والله يدعو إلى دار السلام ويهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم.
Each deed of the seed of Adam is for him except for one. Oh Lord of this blessed month, we praise you for Ramadan. Each deed of the seed of Adam is for him except for one. Oh Lord of this blessed month, we praise you for Ramadan. And for the book you revealed therein to guide us to the light.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How can you become a muhsin in Ramadan? The first area is the people. You're out there. You're still working. You're still driving your car. You're still walking in the street. You're still visiting the stores. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, min hadith Abi Hurairah, radiyallahu an, من لم يدع قول الزور والعمل به من لم يدع قول الزور والعمل به فليس لله حاجة في أن يدع طعامه وشرابه. Whoever does not abandon speaking falsehood or acting falsehood during Ramadan while he's fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not need this person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not mind this person also eating and drinking in the month of Ramadan. Right here, brothers and sisters in Islam, you cannot be fasting and yet be mean and rude. You cannot lie. You cannot backbite. It's against the etiquettes of fasting. Again, remember, you want to be a muhsin in order to earn the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes you will find someone who will bother you while you're fasting. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told you what to do in order to stay a muhsin in the month of Ramadan. إِذَا كَانَ يَوْمُ صَوْمِ أَحَدِكُمْ If it is your day of fasting, فَلَا يَصْخُبْ وَلَا يَجْهَلْ وَإِن سَابَّهُ أَحَدٌ أَوْ قَاتَلَ And if someone curses you or someone hurt you with a word, you know what you should say? إِنِّي صَائِمْ I am fasting. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it's very sad these days. You will find some people losing their temper while they are fasting. And then you go and ask them, why did you do that? They tell you, I'm sorry, I'm fasting. It should be the other way around, that you actually control your temper. You cannot be a muhsin in Ramadan if you do not control your temper. Be amongst those, والكاظمين الغيظ, those who control their anger, والعافين عن الناس, and those who forgive people. والله يحب المحسنين, and Allah loves those who are muhsins. Brothers and sisters in Islam, there is a big misunderstanding regarding strength out there. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam corrects this in a hadith that is recorded by Imam Muslim, hadith Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu anhuma. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Laysa ash-shadidu bis-sur'ah." The strong person is not the person who yells loud, is not the person who beats everybody up. ولكن الشديد من يملك نفسه عند الغضب. But the strong person is the person who controls himself when angry. You need to do this while you're fasting in order to be a muhsin. If you do not do this, brothers and sisters in Islam, you're not a muhsin in Ramadan. You must do this. It takes a lot of practice. You may fail. You may lose it. Try again. Insha'Allah, if you seek the strength from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will give it to you. And show that forgiveness and forbearance to the closest to you, to your family members, to your wife, to your children. Don't get angry at them because you're fasting. Rather, be tolerant, be lenient in the month of Ramadan. This is the first area where you achieve ihsan. What about the second area, which is the area of acts of worship? You know, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that in order to be a Muslim, all you have to pray is the 5 daily prayers. But in order to be a muhsin, you must increase. إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَعُيُونَ. Indeed, the righteous are in gardens and wells. آخذين ما آتاهم ربهم إنهم كانوا قبل ذلك محسنين. They are enjoying what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided for them because they used to be in this dunya محسنين, amongst the محسنين. Look, the next verses defines who are those. Listen. كانوا قليلا من الليل ما يهجعون. They used to pray more than the 5 daily prayers. That's what you need to do. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told you, من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا, praying صلاة التراويح after عشاء, will earn you forgiveness and will make you enter into the area of ihsan. Don't miss on that. Don't pray عشاء and then come back home to watch television in Ramadan. No, don't. Stay in the masjid. Pray taraweeh with your imam and stay behind him until you're done. You will be amongst those, insha'Allah, who will earn forgiveness. Brothers and sisters in Islam, what about sadaqah? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Ramadan, as Abdullah ibn Abbas narrated, and the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, كان أجود الناس. He used to be the most generous of people. وكان أجود ما يكون في رمضان. And he becomes more generous and more generous in Ramadan. When Jibreel عليه السلام used to come and review the Quran with him. Why don't you follow the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and give more sadaqah in Ramadan than the regular, than the norm? Don't worry about the money. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, brothers and sisters, took an oath on this. And the hadith in Sunan al-Tirmidhi, min hadith Abi Kabshat al-Anmari radiyallahu anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, 3 things I'm willing to take an oath on. One of them, ma naqasa malun min sadaqah. Your money will not decrease because of a sadaqah that you pay. Brothers and sisters in Islam, do hajj, do umrah. Hajj, of course, is not in Ramadan, but do umrah. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari as well, min hadith Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, umratun fi Ramadan ka hajjatin ma'i. A umrah that you perform in Ramadan equals to a hajjah, to a hajj, a reward of a hajjah with me. Brothers and sisters in Islam, these are the things that you can do in the area of acts of worship. Ibn Taymiyyah, طيب الله ثراه, called those the heads of the hasanat, رؤوس الحسنات, the heads of the good deeds. Increase in the salah, increase in the sadaqah, perform umrah, and fasting is the worship of the month. Excel in fasting. You will become, insha'Allah, amongst those who are muhsins in the area of acts of worship, in the area of the ibadat. What about the area of your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And you know what? This is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answered Jibreel alayhi salam with. Once he asked him, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inform me about ihsan. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you see Allah. And if you cannot accomplish this, at least be mindful that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala watches you all the time. brothers and sisters in Islam. This is what you need to go for in Ramadan. Be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hatim al-Asam, rahimahullah, and he is one of the predecessors, told us, how can we get there? He said, أرقب نفسك عند ثلاث. Be mindful of yourself in three cases. إذا عملت عملا فاذكر نظر الله إليك. If you do anything, remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking at you. وإذا قلت قولا, and if you speak a word, remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears you. And if you're silent, remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what you're thinking about. Can you do this in Ramadan? If you go and do an act, remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala watching you. في معجم الطبراني, عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما, with his مولى نافع, went out to the desert. And they saw a shepherd coming down from the mountain. Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله عنهما wanted to test that shepherd. He told him, أراعي غنم أنت? You are a shepherd? He said, yes. Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله عنهما told him, why don't you sell me one of your goats or sheep? Look what the shepherd told him, إني مملوك, it's not mine. And I am owned by someone else. Look, Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله عنهما told him, why don't you sell it to me and tell your owner that the wolf ate it? Look what he said. وأين الله? Where is Allah if I do this? Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله عنهما, brothers and sisters in Islam, stayed all night long praying, weeping, and repeating that statement, وأين الله؟ وأين الله؟ Where is Allah؟ Where is Allah؟ In the morning, he found out who's the owner of that shepherd, and he freed him, and he purchased the sheep, the flocks, and he gave it to him. رضي الله عن عبد الله بن عمر, he used to be known of this. It was said that he freed almost 1,000 slaves from slavery. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we have another beautiful example. The mother, when she told her daughter to mix the milk with water, you know what we're talking about. When Umar ibn Khattab رضي الله عنه issued a declaration or a statement that it is forbidden now to mix milk with water, the mother still prompted her daughter to do so. The daughter told the mother, mother, Amir al-Mu'mineen has forbidden us from doing so. The mother told the daughter, Amir al-Mu'mineen is not with us now. The daughter told the mother, but Allah with us now. By the way, Umar al-Khattab رضي الله عنهما insisted, he was Amir al-Mu'mineen at the time, and he heard that conversation, and he insisted that Asim, his son, would marry this daughter, this girl who was conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what you need to do in Ramadan. Insha'Allah, we will continue on next episode with how to be mindful once you speak, and how to be mindful once you are silent, and then we will move forward to another area that inshallah you will enjoy. Do not miss the next episode. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Each deed of the seed of Adam is for him except for one. Oh Lord of this blessed month, we praise you for Ramadan. Each deed of the seed of Adam is for him except for one. Oh Lord of this blessed month, we praise you for Ramadan. And for the book you revealed therein to guide us to the light. By your grace you sent us this Quran each day that we recite. And for the book you revealed therein to guide us to the light.